The Delta variant will be the Philippine government's main consideration in deciding the quarantine classification for next month. That's according to retired General Restituto Padilla, spokesperson of the National Task Force for COVID-19. He says while COVID-19 cases in the National Capital Region are decreasing, the interagency task force is still assessing the situation.
Kung kinakailangan pa naman mag-tweet dahil sa mga kapabagong variant na nakikita natin, maaari din po yun ang gawin natin pero without sacrificing nga yung economy.
The Philippines has so far detected 17 cases of the Delta variant, including one death. The Philippines recorded around 6,000 new COVID-19 cases Sunday. This brings the country's total to nearly 1,398,000. The number of active cases stands at 52,570. Meanwhile, 128 more deaths were reported from the illness, while 6,912 others recovered. The Philippines' vaccine supply gets a big boost with the arrival of more doses. 1 million additional jabs of Sinovac's COVID-19 vaccine arrived Monday morning. The fresh batch will be distributed to areas experiencing COVID-19 surges. The Philippines has so far received 12 million doses from the Chinese pharmaceutical firm.
Nakita natin on last Friday, nakuha na natin yung 10 million. Sa ngayon, gusto ko rin ibalita na 100% na tayo sa healthcare workers. In terms ng master listed, nakuha na natin lahat. 1,600,000 ang nakuha na natin sa master listed ng healthcare workers. So we are now pursuing yung second dose nila.
The Philippines also received its first shipment of Moderna's drug. Nearly 250,000 doses were delivered Sunday night. These will be shared by the government and private companies.
Yung mga economic frontliners talaga. Yun ang most of the companies are really have been open during the entire pandemic, essential service. So they'll be prioritized, teachers, ang dami pang iba.
The Philippine government is looking to inoculate 58 million Filipinos this year to achieve herd immunity. The Philippine Health Department vowing to improve its vaccination protocol after a certain individual did not receive a proper dose. See, in a video filmed by the prospective vaccine recipient, the health worker was caught failing to inject the full contents of the syringe. The health department says that was a clear breach of protocols. The individual was immediately given another shot after the gaffe. The agency vows to take the incident seriously as it reminds all vaccinators to take extra care and make that attention during inoculation. A civil engineer specializing in wind dynamics calls the use of face shields in the fight against COVID-19 redundant. Engineer Joshua Agar says face masks and physical distancing are already enough to ensure that respiratory droplets don't spread from person to person. He says face shields may even make people more vulnerable to the virus.
You introduce the face shield, it acts as an insulating layer. So the heat that's radiating from your body is building up underneath the face shield. Also, the moisture is also building up. So basically, you're making the particles in the air sticky. So they would be attracted to your skin there, then they would stick there.
There has been widespread clamor to drop government's face shield mandate. Government, however, insists on keeping it due to the threat posed by new, more transmissible COVID-19 variants.